Okay, I'm a trader. I don't do it to sell or any bullshit like that.
How can I get a copy?
I'll give you my email. Just like send me a blank page.
Really?
Yeah.
Great.
Thank you.
mind control.
Shredding, chopping, trail, boy, long time.
machine, not enough water. Last night, too much liquor and not enough sleep. But I'm all good. I'm fine. I'm, you know, it's all fine. It's just, I'll sweat it out. That we make, isn't it? My conclusion is liquor's awesome.
Dancing on the ground, and I'm right.
Thank you all very much. That's Tim Reynolds. I haven't introduced you to my friend Tim Reynolds. For coming to spend this evening hanging out with us. Hope we do a good job, really. Hope we do all right. Masturbation. Some people drink tea. Some people have beer. Some people...
Jack Daniels!
Some people masturbate. And some people do all of the above. Yeah, it's a great thing. Show us, did you say that? Shit. I hope that wasn't what you said. But you can figure it out. Get in the bathtub, hang out with yourself for a while, I'm pretty sure. Stupid and a little bit of an egomaniac to want to be president, I think. So I hope I'm neither of them, but I probably am. So.
How does that do what you all do? Do.
I thought it seemed really silly when I was hearing about it, but then I thought it was kind of cool. Watched it lying in my hotel room. It's Pleasantville. That's a fun movie, man. There's some fun shit going on in there. So you know the director had to be on acid at one point. I mean, maybe not, but I mean, at least he's experimenting. It was cool, it was cool. Oh, here's awesome and acid over here again. Yeah. He's so delicate. You're so delicate and poetic. That's the gift that keeps on giving.
star is spinning. One sweet world, and in her breath I'm swimming, and here we will rest in peace.
Kaka and doggy piddle. Do you know that bulls, when they see a cow having a piddle, then they go over to the cow in the hopes that they'll be able to get their nose under the stream. But if they can't, and then if they can't even get there, they sniff the place where it was, where it landed. And then they, with a look of sort of ecstasy in their eyes, they look up at the sky and they go. Mm-hmm. Bulls know what's going on. We gotta go all the way to Sweden for that kind of weird shit. You've been to Sweden, they look all blonde and pure over there. Weird folks over there in Sweden. They got nothing to do but pee on each other. Relax, fool.
What's up?
Cheers. I've got too much lightness. I've got too much lightness. That's my boy. Thank you. Before, I'm sure I have. I don't know if I told it to you, but speaking of boogers, I had this super crush on this woman. Man, oh, good God. so fun. I was like 15 or something. You weren't quite born yet, but I was like 15 or something, and Tanya, good God. I made best friends with her neighbor, just so this guy was in my school, just so I could check her out as often as possible, because she was always over at his house, swimming at his house. He had a real nice pool. And so she and I were swimming one time, and it was starting to, you know, stars were starting to shine, and she was giving me that look, and I was giving her that look, and, you know, something, you know, I don't know what it was, but I was giving it to her anyway, you know. And things were going well, and she was pulling that real sexy move where you know, coming out of the water like in commercials and stuff. She's coming out of the water like, you know, she's coming out of it like this. It's all just dripping down off her head. She came out, and she's in, and she had the, like, lime green, big. Going over her mouth. It was just really a shock to my system. And then I said, you know, you gotta look, because you can't look, you got a great big lime green booger hanging off your face. Will you marry me? You know? So I said, you gotta look something. So she went down. But that forever changed our relationship. But just that one time, and it shows how shallow I am, but it really did. It was a shocker, you know. And then, when we were closer to my 20s, I think. We closed the deal, I think. I think we did. I can't really. I may wish I'd be blowing my own trumpet in Geneva. I can't quite remember it. Oh, there's that last. There's a loud, nasty motherfucker. I'm not going to give you those details. Just tell you that it was a special time.
She really, all she says are
lost her. Everybody is missing, so went away. I couldn't tell you, I couldn't tell you. I'm okay, I'm okay. I once had a girl, or should I say she once had me.
But it's a great tune. It's a tune by La Love It.
Yeah. And if I had a boat, I'd go out on the ocean. And if I had a pony, I'd ride him on my boat. And we could all together go out on the ocean. If I were a Rogers, I'd sure enough be single. Couldn't bring myself to marry an old Dale. So it'd just be me and Trevor. We'd ride off through the movies. We'd buy a boat and on the sea we'd sail. And if I had a boat, I'd go out on the ocean. And if I had a pony, go out on the ocean, just me up on my pony, on my boat. The mystery masked man was smart, he got himself a Tonto, cause Tonto did the dirty work for a fee. But Tonto, he was smarter, and one day said, Kimosabe, kiss my ass, I bought a boat, I'm going out to sea. And if I had a pony, I'd ride him on my boat. And we could all together go out on the ocean. Just me up on my pony, on my boat. And if I were like lightning, I wouldn't need no sleep. I'd come and go whenever I would please. I'd scare him by the shady tree and scare him by the light post. But I would not scare my pony or my boat out on the sea. But if I had a boat, I'd go out on the ocean. And if I had a pony, I'd ride him on my boat. And we could all together go out on the ocean.
God, I'm falling to pieces or something. I don't know what's happening over here. The shit starts falling off, tell me, would you? Feels like having a little speed wobble. We all have speed wobbles, though. Mm-hmm. Well, I get it. Is it the Utica water? Don't drink the Utica water. I knew I was missing a word for this.
Thank you.
told me.
Robert Lardell.
He told me that it should be a law that anytime anyone screams Freebird, that the band has to play it. And it's see, I'm gonna take people to stop screaming that shit. Cause, good God. I mean, it's great, man.
Just give me one thing.
hope you're all enjoying yourselves this evening.
Say goodbye!
Say goodbye!
Shit.
I got it.
Say goodbye!
Breath over here. Man. I was riding a horse one time, and this Hollywood dude, this Hollywood guy lives near my house, Denny or something. But he moved to Virginia. He wanted to get away from that crazy Hollywood life. I was like, well, go the fuck back. Anyway, but you know, we bumped into each other, so we became chummy. You know, he came to my house with a camera and was taking photos for a potential commercial. I was like, not at this house. Get him out of here. But then we talked a little bit, and he said, I've got horses, so why don't you come over to our place and you can ride. I'd love it. So anyway, so we jump on the horses, and he comes riding across. You guys been on a horse for a week or something. He just still ain't got a clue. So I jump up on the horse, and me and my sweetheart go riding around in the paddock. But this horse, every time I get up to a good run, I was like, yeah. The horse would turn into like a bucking bronco or whatever. It just start going, and I was holding on for dear life. My girlfriend said I looked hot because I was looking like one of those dudes, you know. I was just like, shit. I was going scared shit. And he just like jumping. He just like, and he'd jump. And then he'd chill out. I'm like, okay, chill, fuck out. And then start off again and say, hey, everything's cool, walk a little ways. Let's try and see a gallop again. And I'd like dig my feet into, not too hard, just like a little kank. And he'd do these launches, like, and then be like, and then in the middle of it, you do the kank, kank, kank. And I was like, God damn, what are you doing? Anyway, so he was wreaking the traffic on my testicles. It was just but I wasn't gonna give up, And then, but you know, that's not the funniest part of the story, but the hands up, I go back and take the saddle off Denny. Denny had put the saddle on, you know? But he didn't know how to put a fucking saddle on a horse, so he knotted, did some little knot right underneath the saddle. And this horse had a big dent in his back. And I just wanted to knock Denny out. When I took that saddle off, I said, what the you trying to kill me and get the money or something, aren't you, stupid ass? God damn it. And this horse, because Denny said, I can put the saddle on. Don't help me, farmhand. I can put the saddle on. I'm from Hollywood. I've seen it in the movie for years. You just throw it on there and strap it in. It's California dreaming. Thank you.
justifying to you. This land is your land, this land is my land.
Work the
Have you seen the oldest daughters standing there with broken wings? I have seen the flaming sword there over Stavridan, burning in the eyes of the maker, burning in the eyes of the maker, burning.
Check that out. It's on an album called Acadia. It's a bad, bad album. Good God. Daniel Lenoir.
Play number 40!
It wasn't a booger. It was a booger. Lip booger or something. God. You're losing your mind, not you.
Thank you.
Suck it up, yeah. I said, Do you lay so? Play with us like this girl and the girl.
feel like a real weirdo today. I just feel really weird. You know, some days you're a little left of center. And today, I'm always hungover, but I'm a little left of center today. It's a sad thing. I'm one of those really nice drunks. You know, I'm not like that horrible kind of drunk that gets loud and mean. I'm one of those really cheerful drunks that nobody will tell you except for your sister that you have a problem, you know. And then once I go from like really happy guy to this dude. Yeah, that's what happens to me. Really clever bastard I am. Shit happens. Where'd you get that? That's an original one. I'll do little thing but it's gonna be sung by this sad drunk lady at a bar. She's just so drunk she can't get up. And she can't see straight. But she knows she's bummed out, that's about it.
Thank you.
I'm seeking you. I take a taste of what's mellow. Come away into something better. While that one is what I've not got, and what I need is all around me. I reach and search and never stop. And I say, just
paralyzed from my schizophrenia that was there. Him doing it once, Paul Simon hitting me and Julio, I just want to tell you this, I heard a tape of Paul Simon doing it, and I mean maybe one day, but at the time, and it's still sticking with me now, I said to myself, I never want to play that motherfucker again, because that thing, he tore it up, he hit the band, he had all those African dudes, really, they just, you know, go down, 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 and then we're up there like, you know, it was just one the same thing, you know, so I'm kind of, you know, that'd be my reason for being that we were all together, the whole band was together when we all listened to them, but we were listening to the radio, and all of a sudden we were like, God damn, that smokes us.
Give it a
try! Like alone, until later, they
watchtower. The Bansons kept our view. Yeah. sometimes.